Rube Goldberg. Oh.
You want to know about
Rube Goldberg? That takes me back, it does.
Oh boy. Well, we had us make this Rube Goldberg machine, and it had to make a Lunchable. Now, Lunchable is a crazy thing. It's dough, crackers, cheese, ham. Now, not only did it have to be a Rube Goldberg machine, we had to work with 7 other teams, including our own, to make one thing, one giant Rube Goldberg machine. I had a lot of crackers not working and paint all over me. I had so many things go wrong.
No!
I couldn't list them all here in this interview. I think it'd just be too long.
I don't want to relive that terrible time in my life.
So, if you go too weird or crazy, like, I wouldn't pick this team to go like, hey, I'm gonna have that win.
Yes, I'm sorry.
What I hope is the students learn that communication is the biggest obstacle to any kind of team project.
I reckon.
Does it look like ham, or does it need to be lighter?
So definitely lighter.
A fish out.
And so my goal is that they become a little bit more understanding of each other when they're trying to work with each other.
Just been trying to, you know, control my team. My leader was gone today. And my design team. And some of my builders. But it's fine. I'm fine.
Like 100 or so people, like, with one communal shared goal. That's the part that I'm, like, a little iffy on.
Oh boy, it's stressful.
I was sent off to war in the first few days, so I wasn't there for most of the engineering as the engineer.
See, you know, I was out here filming everything, you know. It just didn't work out. Like, we were gonna do this big, you know, cinematic short film, but then that didn't work.
While we were making this, you know, it didn't work.
We just tallied every single time it failed. And we ended up with a paper filled with tallies.
The more we tried to build the thing, the more it kind of just kept breaking.
The story is dead.
I did that!
Question!
Back Wait. Off!
Yes, we had all the different tables. We had to move it from the ensemble room to the band room. We brought the tables in, we connected it. There were sometimes some items would fall apart on the tables, but, you know, we were able to put it back together. In the end, we ended up with a beautiful final project.
Oh, yes, today is Rube Day, and today is going to be amazing and slay, and we're gonna have a successful run through all of the machines, and everybody here knows what I mean, because,
woo! Yeah!
That wasn't my fault one bit.
Now, if any of you know a little something about a Rube Goldberg machine, you don't want those last steps to be bad.
I take no responsibility. The mousetrap was cool.
Oh, yeah, there was one other boy. It was Trygg. He was also filming. He was a filmer. Indeed.
Yeah. So I was one of the main film people on the Rube project. Yeah, I was in charge of documenting it, of, you know, collecting footage, what have you, just, you know, documenting stuff. You know, people might have complained a lot, but, you know, they made something. You know, people might look back on the project and be like, what the heck was that all about? What even was that? Why, what? What point does that have to do with anything? That is the most hyper-specific weird thing you could possibly ever do on such a grand scale. And I just tell them, I think it was worth it.
We kind of got it to run once, and you know, that's all that it needed.
I think all of the machines look beautiful, and everybody did a great job.
It all ended up being good.
So there are these two rats, right? And one of them is evil, and one of them is good.
In the end, it was worth it.
And we got so close, and it never worked.
I feel victorious about the way it ended. I feel like my group, as they said back in the day, slayed.
I wish that mousetrap worked.
I believe that this event has shifted the course of my life. I don't think it was worth it.
We worked together as a team with a lot of team work.
I think Rube Goldberg was a wonderful thing for me to be doing in my youth. The teamwork, the spirit, the edumacating that was done, it was wonderful.
Don't cry, don't raise your eyes. It's all